Hi, let's talk about North Star Matric. I recommend, before watching this video, to watch video about metrics. Okay, so one metrics that matters. So it's one indicator for business, growth, and marketing. So it's reflect the value we provide to customers. As bigger North Star Matric is, as much we provide value for customers. So we increase these metrics, we increase our growth, we increase our income, we increase the value a customer gets from our product. So firstly, we can measure it, so because it's metrics. And it's at the same time, it's effect and product and marketing. So product team work on this and marketing team worked on this, and also shareholders following the metrics. And by the way, these metrics measured not by money. Why? Because this metrics shows main value for the customer. More value, more money. Let's go deeper. So the metrics reflects business growth. The metrics could be tracked in dynamics. So usually metrics we just increase is like is grow, low, grow, grow, grow. So next month start. So she start growing again. It's like income. You need to grow it every month and measure it every month. And what is important is that everybody trusts these metrics. Everybody in your company trusts these metrics. And everybody involved. Developers said, we need this feature because North Star metrics will be better. So everybody in the business not talking exactly about money. They're talking about North Star metric. So it's one metric that matters. So there are three types of products: attention, transactions, and productivity. So let's talk deep about every of them. So attention. It means we focus on attention. And the main idea how we fight for the customer attention. So Facebook North Star metric is total time spent engaging with the content. What this means? If more users watching content, it means shareholders are happy because people get more ads. It means like developers are happy because people using the product, and also marketing team is happy because they need more views, they can sell more ads. So time spent growing, everybody is happy on Facebook. So in Google, if like users spend more than 5 minutes per day, so they calculate only users, not who using Google one time per day, but people who use Google at least 5 minutes per day. So Netflix story views, because stories, if more people watch stories, it means more people more people sharing. So all metrics grows, and of course more ads, shareholders are happy. So Netflix subscribers, so it means subscribers, not users, subscribers streaming more than 60 hours per month. So only very active subscribers. So they focus on people who watch them for a long time. And by the way, Netflix invests a lot to fight with people sleeping, like dreaming. While you're sleeping or dreaming, you're not watching Netflix. So they focus so you sleep less and watch Netflix. And so they are, to increase North Star metric, you need to see Netflix more than 60 hours per month. So with YouTube, very easily, just daily watch time. All users together, how much they spent watching the video. Of course, they watch video more, investors get more money, their all ecosystem grows. And Spotify, time spent on listening, similar as YouTube and similar as Facebook. So they fight for the attention. So let's go to the other type, of products, transactions products. So transactions products focus on regular monthly transactions. So Uber, we don't use Uber every day. Sometimes we use it like 12 times a day. Sometimes we maybe 5 days we don't use it. So they get rides booked, I don't remember, weekly or monthly, but the idea, the keys, rides booked. Not how many times we opened the app, how fast we did it, but like how many rides were booked. Amazon, purchases per Prime subscribers. So what is important for Amazon? They have about 500 million subscribers, Prime subscribers. So they need premium users, purchases from them. So they don't need regular guys who order something from Europe if they're not subscribers. No, they need Prime subscribers who buy very often and do transactions very often. So, night booked for Airbnb. So, because it covers everything. If night booked, it means there are lots of flats, lots of users, lots of everything. They need more popular flats, more users who make bookings. So, and of course, they provide more money, more value for the apartment owners. So all ecosystem works. Bookings, all ecosystem works. And Aeroflot, of course, for biggest, for seats purchases. And by the way, Aeroflot is the biggest Amplitude customer in Russia. And by the way, Amplitude, it's, I don't know, like pioneer in this, in Star Matric. So usually Amplitude try to advertise this matrix. Possibly for Amplitude, Star Matric is companies who use Star Matric, by the way. Because the idea, if you're usually quite adult to understand why you need it, usually we'll use Amplitude for this, but it's not the rule. My personal opinion for Amplitude is that companies who use Star Matric as their Star Matric. Okay, and productivity company. That company focus on productivity. So for Salesforce, they track records. Because if your company is lucky, you put more records, you have more sales, and they're lucky because they charge you for their records. Also Evernote. Notes created by premium subscribers. They do not track everybody, but for premium subscribers, how many premium users? So they also like involved money here. So not free users. Slack of messages sent. Because Slack charge for messages. So, and the main value for them is message. So as many messages team members send to each other, as much Slack shareholders and team is happy. So for Microsoft, of course, for users who complete the task. So of course, for Miro, if the how many shared active boards, the Miro is not happy when you have many boards. Miro is happy when you have shared boards. And skyeng has number of lessons. How many number of lessons? By the way, now they switch to the directly to the money. Maybe right now they're switching to other metrics, so they switching from Star Matric to money, but still earlier they did it before they become billion company, they charge lessons. Of course, how calculate Star Matric? Usually we can make the decomposition to four pieces. First is breadth. So how many returning users are taking this action? So first is active users. Second is depth. How depth is engagement. Third is frequency. How often does user engage? And efficiency. How fast do they succeed or do they succeed? So I will explain a little bit better this example, so you will understand better. Let's say company Instacart. They deliver food. So what is the breadth? So user placing orders each month. Okay, so we calculate users who are placing orders each month. So dev, items with order. Of course, we need more users and we need more items. Nice. So frequency, how many orders completed? Of course, they would like to focus so the users do transactions very often. Several times per month. Better several times per hour, of course. And efficiency. Orders delivered in time. So the idea, if order wasn't delivered in time, it do not increase the North Star metric. So what is the roadmap? Roadmap is, they need more users for breadth. They need new users, new signups. So they need more simplified trials, because more simplified trials, more signups. And of course, the trial conversion. For dev, they of course, when you buy three things, they can recommend you four things. Users who buy sneakers usually buy Coke. For example, provide shopping links, so it's much easier for you to order. And some discounts, coupons. Okay, they see that you are ready to click checkout, they can offer you something. Hey guys, like discounts for today. Frequency. So possibly you do not buy this week. So what they recommend? Like they do flash sales. They can do notifications, for example, how. Or for example, stock management. They, for example, if something, they have lots, I don't know, lots of, let's say, bananas, they can do like flash sales because they do stock management and something, sometimes remove something, old things from the stock as well. And efficiency. How they can introduce efficiency? They can analyze, do some algorithms to analyze why it wasn't delivered in time. And of course they can provide like customer chat so they can like get informed before and like react it much faster so they can deliver more. So the idea is, this is just an example how to make decomposition for North Star. And as you see, like every vertical increase. If you would like to double your metrics, let's say 1.2 multiply 1.2 multiply 1.2 multiply 1.2, so it's like 20% to each, more than double your North Star and value for the customer. So that is. So do practice, do your homework. So understood, what is your product? Are you fighting for attention? Are you fighting for transactions or your productivity tool? So formulate your North Star metrics. We did it maybe for our companies four times, and still every time is not easy. So usually it's easy to formulate, but when you try to do decomposition, it's really nice thinking process, because you really know where to focus your business. It's very nice. And of course, define inbound metrics. So once you have understood your product type, understood what is your North Star metric, you need to do decomposition. So thank you for your time. And if you would like to complete everything about metrics, also, as I said earlier, I recommend you to watch video about metrics. And also, our funnel, it's really also very recommended. See you on the next video.